Well, Rupert, we made it.
It's beautiful up here. So, should we just sprinkle him around randomly, or...
Oh, don't be a savage, Brian. What is your problem? We have to have the ceremony first. Dearest Rupert, we're here. I never wanted this to happen.
He was always there whenever Stewie needed him. He was understanding. He always listened. He made Stewie a better person. Stewie and I are both incredibly grateful for all the time we had with you, and we wouldn't change a single moment. Except the end. Sorry about that.
Outweigh the band.
I thought we'd get to see forever, but forever's gone away.
It's so hard to say goodbye.
Is going to be all I know is where we've been and what we've been through. Ooh. If we get
rain after the rain, it's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday.
Send in, Stewie, please.
Oh, I can go in now? Oh, fantastic. He's ready. Marvelous. Thank you, Barbara. I hope you get those Adele tickets. You deserve them. She won't get them. No way. She needed to get them like a month ago. So, Oh, don't act like you don't know who she is. Please, that doesn't impress me. We live in the world. We all know who Bethany Frankel is, whether we like it or not. You know, I actually don't mind her. And she's built quite a business for herself. You have to hand it to her. I don't mean to name drop, but I kind of know Andy Cohen. I guess I'm his type. Which, of course, is very flattering. He's outrageously... Oh, look, you got your Dunkin' Donuts coffee. I don't know why those cups always depress me. It's like you've already given up before the day's even started. You might as well tattoo "Can't Afford Starbucks" on your forehead. What do I care, though? None of my business. I haven't heard of any of the schools you went to, but I'm sure they were great.
What is it you'd like me to say, Stewie?
That I have a British accent.
I apologize, but I can't hear it.
You mean to tell me you don't hear me speaking with a British accent right now?
No.
That's odd, because everybody else does.
Have you spent much time in Britain, then?
No, I haven't.
Excuse me?
I said no! But you're the absolute only person who hasn't noticed it. You do feel you know me a bit. Okay, all right. Well, that's fair. Might I?
I'm not sure how this is going to help.
Indulge me. Thank you. I see you're on vacation in Rio de Janeiro in this photo with your partner, I'm guessing? Or is he your husband? With a sonnet or monologue each day. And no one had ever done anything so romantic as reciting Shakespeare for Michael before. And he was smitten. While not as physically attracted to you as you are to him, that's okay. You each bring something important to the relationship. Isn't that what you believe, Dr. Pritchfield? I see a prescription for heart medication on that table. Sends you over the years. Michael likes to travel, and he prefers the finer things, and you'd like to give them to him, wouldn't you? But it's a bit difficult on a child psychologist's salary at a Rhode Island preschool, I'd imagine. Fortunately, you don't have children, so you do have some disposable income. Oh, you have talked about it with other couples, just for show. Probably at dinner with younger friends of Michael's who are starting a family summer vacation, which is in fact winter in Rio, outside of the high tourist season. And I see that you're on the rooftop pool deck at the Fasano Hotel in Ipanema, the most exclusive hotel in all of Brazil. Michael would have been dying to stay there. He had a friend that went with his older boyfriend, who makes a lot of money in most likely banking, much to your chagrin. But even in August, it's almost $1,000. Most people never get to visit half the places he's seen, you tell him. You can't help but feel like a bit of a failure as you see the look of disappointment on his face as he enters the room. So you decide to go to the Fasano Hotel for dinner and drinks. No, just drinks. Once you've seen the restaurant prices online, and once there, you can see how Michael begins looking at all the older men who can afford to take their boyfriends. I'm sorry, husbands. Everybody here. So Michael calls over a young man wearing a tiny swimsuit to take the photo and makes a crude joke that embarrasses you, but the young man laughs. And he and Michael share a moment that you're not part of, and you feel humiliated and unseen. Which explains Michael's joyful grin and your slightly disconnected half-smile. And you've posted the photo on Facebook, and Michael's posted it to his 86 followers on Instagram. You can see inside my soul! Oh, God! Thank you. Thank you, Barbara. Oh, God! Oh, God.
It seems like you're keeping a lot bottled up inside.
I am. Nobody here likes me, Dr. Pritchfield. I try to fit in with the other boys and talk about things like dirt and shapes, but they won't play with me, and I don't have any friends, and I have nobody to eat lunch with.
It's very interesting you'd say that you have no friends, Stewie.
Look, Dr. Pritchfield, Cecil, if I may.
It's pronounced Cecil.
Damn it!
But again, how would you know? It's not as if you're...
Okay, we got it. I only pushed Tyler down the stairs because I like him, and I'm afraid he won't like me back. And not like him. I'm not gay. This whole thing isn't because I'm gay, so calm down. I can already see you licking your chops. Okay, it just sounded strange for a second.
It must be difficult for you, Stewie, being so intelligent.
It is. Oh, just that acknowledgement. You know, sometimes I don't know where I fit in. I just want to be like everybody else, but nobody's interested in the things that I'm interested in. It's hard to find someone who can converse on one of those topics, let alone both. And I really, really, really want to see Hamilton, but by the time it gets here, I'll be 30. I think I'm still the only one in town who's even heard of it, and it's been out for over 2 years, which just makes me even more depressed. How do you live in a place like that? Quahog. What a pile of garbage. How does a bastard, orphan, son of a whore and a Scotsman, dropped in the middle of a forgotten spot in the Caribbean by Providence, impoverished in squalor, grow up to be a hero and a scholar? The $10 founding father without a father got a lot farther by working a lot. Well, the word got around, and they said, this kid is insane, man. Took up a collection just to send him to the mainland. Get your education, don't forget from whence you came, and the world's gonna know your name. What's your name, man? Alexander Hamilton. We don't have that at our house. My mother boils water in an old Jiffy Pop tin. She's just a useless old slut. Hey, my hiccups are gone.
If you liked Tyler and you wanted to be friends with him, then why did you push him down the stairs?
Oh, I don't know.
Can I tell you a story about another little boy?
And
neither was father. You see, I was the sole survivor of my family. So I was sent to live with an aunt in Cornwall. But she had too many mouths of her own to feed, so I was next sent to a distant cousin in Northumberland. But she didn't care for children, and off again I went, this time to an orphanage in Gloucestershire. You have to pretend that you're something you're not. Oh, and also, how my first kiss was with a Nazi.
See? We didn't need to go back 1,000 years for that. And I don't pretend I'm something I'm not.
I never said that.
You just said it.
I might have implied it. I suppose the question is, why you feel the need to do that?
I don't know. I guess constructed persona designed to keep people at arm's length. This isn't even how I really talk. This is how I talk. The accent is nothing more than an affectation, a coat of armor to get me through the day, just an image I cultivated so I could feel special. Wow. What a relief. For once, like a weight has been lifted. I can finally be myself.
I like this, Stewie. I hope he stays for a while.
I've never been vulnerable to anyone before. You're the only one who's ever met the real me.
Well, I'm honored, and now the rest of the world is going to meet him.
Yes. Yes, that's right. There's no going back now. I'm special. Oh, God, what was I thinking? I'm never going to lift the veil. Ever. Nobody will ever know the real me. My accent's back, by the way. It was a very dramatic moment.
If you say so. Now, let's talk about... Stewie.
I guess that's what happens in therapy, though.
No, it's not.
Ah, you're right. That didn't make much sense. Not to sound ghoulish, but any indication how much longer you're going to linger?
I'm not sure. I think it's different for everyone.
Yeah, because you're still pretty chatty, is why I'm wondering.
Don't do this, Stewie. It will stay with you forever.
Yeah, not worried. Macbeth?
Romeo and Juliet. But I wouldn't expect you to know, since you're not in any way. British.
Hey, Bri?
Yeah?
Would you mind maybe sleeping with me tonight?
Sure.
Thanks.
Good night, Stewie.
Night, Brian. Brian?
Yeah?
I did something awful.
Do you want to talk about it?
Hello, flabby, out-of-shape family. Check out my bulging rippliness.
Peter, you've been to the gym once. For 15 minutes.
And I'm 15 minutes stronger, Brian. I'd rip a phone book in half, but for the life of me, I don't know anyone who uses a phone book anymore. So I'll use Meg's laptop.
Dad! What the hell?
Thanks, Mom. Hey, Doc, what did you do with my mom's fat?
Oh, it's right here in the storage closet.
It's exactly what it looks like. Hey, if I'm fat, then Stewie's fat, too, because we wear the same size onesie.
Oh, sorry to interrupt. I just came to clear the search history off my computer before the IT guy... he's already got it.
And you know what's right around the corner?
The strip club where they spit in your face?
No, the dog park.
Hello?
Yeah, Merry Christmas. Listen, Peter, can you turn down those lights? I'm in bed with a three, and, extra light is not her friend.
Come on, you can't be... I'll look at Quagmire trying to sneak that three out of his house.